I'm here with Jacques, our lead front-end engineer. Hi.
Hi.
So, documentation. Love it, hate it.
You really need it.
You really need it?
Yeah, it's not the best, it's not the most fun thing to write. It's the most amazing thing when you start working on a project and there is documentation.
So what about reading documentation?
Reading documentation is a core thing that engineers do all the time.
So if I were to give you an API or a piece of software or something like that and ask you to work with it, and let's say that I didn't allow you to use documentation, would your productivity, okay, and also let's say that you were 100% productive before, without documentation, where would you be?
Oh, it would be in the 20% range.
I mean, really?
Yeah, well, because you're going to have to parse. I mean, it depends on how big the code is. You know, I can read through it and sort of figure out what's going on if I have access to that code, if it's not just a black box.
Yeah.
But even then, you know, I mean, that means that I have to go through and fully understand the inner workings of what somebody else has come up with. And without documentation, that's hard. That's a lot of time spent understanding something that could have been very easily handled with this hands back this object.
So what would you say to students who are taking our course, who are learning to read documentation? I mean, like, I know when I first started programming, I had a huge resistance to reading documentation. And furthermore, I felt like it reflected negatively about me as a programmer. Like, I don't already know this. I'm looking up string.split or something like that, which I use all the time. What's wrong with me?
Absolutely nothing. I mean, it's programming, you know, we're making, you're taking an idea about what you want it to do, and, you know, what you want your code to do, and turning it into reality, right? And the nitty-gritty of what the fourth argument for this built-in API is not really an important thing, right? You know, and if it's something you use literally all of the time, it'll eventually get stuck in your head. And until then, just look it up. It absolutely does not reflect poorly on you. We look up stuff all the time, and it's stuff from the most arcane randomness that you can think of, all the way down to how are we going to split a string, right? I mean, that comes up, and if you don't have it on the top of your head, if it's faster for you to go look it up than it is to sit there and try and type a bunch of things into the console and figure it out, go look it up.
So it seems almost like it's like writing with English. So if you're writing a paper and you are looking up a word, for example, and you look it up again and again and again, eventually it'll get stuck in your brain. But the fact that you don't have it the second time doesn't reflect negatively on you as a human being or as
no.
a writer.
No, absolutely not. I mean, as an engineer, your ability to be an engineer, to be an effective engineer, is not that you have everything committed to memory. If you use something enough, it'll be in there.
So it's not memorization.
Absolutely not.
It's building with pieces, and then if you don't remember how to use the pieces or the tools, then you look it up.
Exactly. And I mean, if you were to hold up an engineer who knows every little nitty bit about some package or framework or whatever and makes terrible programming decisions versus somebody who makes good programming decisions and looks everything up, this guy is the guy you want on your team.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, so don't be afraid to look things up. It's important.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Thanks, Jacques.